Hello and welcome to this algorithm tutorial for beginners. Now, in computer science, an algorithm is a complete set of steps or a method to perform some work. Human beings also use algorithms to complete tasks. You may have been using some algorithm to get dressed, another algorithm to get from A to B. An algorithm needs some space, meaning memory, and some time to execute. An algorithm typically takes some input. An algorithm produces some output. Numerous algorithms are used in computer science. These range from simple algorithms like various sorting algorithms to algorithms that parse text, generate computer graphics, encrypt or decipher data, or even make intelligent decisions. Now let us see an example algorithm. This algorithm finds the smallest number in a list of numbers. The input to this algorithm is a list of numbers, say n. The output of this algorithm is the smallest number in the list n. Notice that the language used to write this algorithm is similar to any programming language. This kind of code is called pseudo code. Now let us see this algorithm step by step. Step 1. If n.size is 0, meaning there are no numbers in the list, return the output null. Step 2. Get some space to store a variable called smallest. Assign the first number in the list, which is n0, to smallest. This left arrow means assign. Step 3. Loop through each item in the list n. Step 3.1. Check if the current item is less than smallest. Step 3.1.1. If yes, meaning if item is less than smallest, assign item to smallest. This means that if the algorithm comes across an item smaller than the value in the smallest variable, it updates the smallest variable to that item. In other words, this algorithm remembers the smallest item it has seen in the list so far. Also notice the indentation. The step if is executed for each time the for loop runs. So that is why it is indented under the for statement. Step 4. Return the output as the value in the smallest variable. Now these four steps are the complete set of steps to find the smallest number in a list of numbers. Now this algorithm takes the input, which is the list n, that we have to give as input whenever we want to use this algorithm. Now this algorithm needs space for the variable smallest, just for the variable smallest. Also this algorithm needs time to run. It needs time to return the output, so the return statement takes some time to execute. There is another return here. It needs time to assign value to a variable. For example, smallest is equal to n0. This takes some time. If a smaller item is there, then smallest is equal to item will be executed. This also takes time. And the comparison also takes time by comparing the current item with the smallest. Each Iteration of the for loop also takes some time. If n is a large list of numbers, this algorithm will spend most of its runtime in step 3 only, because it has to go through each and every item in that large list of numbers. This algorithm produces an output. The output is null if n is an empty list, else it produces the output which is the smallest number in the list. You can test this algorithm by taking a list of 4 or 5 numbers and see whether it finds the smallest number in that list or not. Or you could implement this algorithm in the programming language that you know and then test that program. That is all for this tutorial, and see you in the next tutorial. Thank you.